Hello guys, welcome back. So my name is Irwin Thomas Wilson, and today we will be talking about another interesting topic in criminal law, and that is criminal intimidation. What is criminal intimidation? So general definition is to threaten someone, to coerce someone, to force someone into doing something, or restrain from doing something like that. So the offense of criminal intimidation is defined under section 503 of the IPC. The provision states that anyone who threatens any other person on the there are certain grounds given in IPC. So the grounds that that is given are that is threatens to cause injury to the other person, threatens to cause injury to the reputation of other person, threatens to cause injury to the property of other person, threatens to cause injury to the person or reputation of anyone in whom the person is interested. So these all can amount to criminal intimidation. So moving further, the intention should be to cause alarm to that person or to make them perform any act which they are not legally bound to do, or to omit any act which are legally entitled to perform. If they are forced to do all of these acts as a mean to avoid execution of such threat, this amounts to criminal intimidation. So the explanation of this section states that a threat to injure the reputation of a deceased person in whom the person threatened is interested is also covered under this section. So example of a criminal intimidation: A, for the purpose of inducing B to refrain from filing a complaint against him, threatens to kill B's wife. A is liable to be punished for the offense of criminal intimidation. So there are some key points to be kept in mind while we file a complaint for criminal intimidation. So in a recent judgment in Tripura High Court, in the case Sri Padma Mohan Jamatia versus Srimati Jarnadas, it was observed that mere use of abusive words or filthy language and body posture during the speech of a political leader is not included within the radius or the legal radius of criminal intimidation that is defined under 503. So now let's move further and see what is the extent of nature of the threat. So it is not necessary that the threat is direct in nature. So in an old case, A.K. Gopalan versus the state of Madras, the court held that if a speaker at a public meeting threatened police officers stationed with injury to their person, property or reputation, then he was liable for committing the offense of criminal intimidation. In the case of Anuradha, in another case of Anuradha versus state of Maharashtra, the accused allegedly threatened the female teachers by shouting the teachers shouting that the teacher should be caught by their hair, kicked on their waist and pulled out of the hall. So the Bombay High Court ruled that these remarks constituted the offense of criminal intimidation. So next we will see the nature of injury threatened. So in the case of Nandakishore versus Emperor, so this is a pre-independence case. In this case, a butcher who sold beef was threatened that if he indulged in the acts of buying or selling beef, then he would be sent to jail. So, further, his living in the municipality was also threatened. The court held that this amounted to criminal intimidation. Now, let's see, what is the punishment for criminal intimidation? So, the punishment for the offense of criminal intimidation is laid down under section 506 of the Indian Penal Code. So the provision is divided into two parts. So in simple cases of criminal intimidation, whoever commits criminal intimidation is liable to be punished with imprisonment for a period which may extend to 2 years, or a fine, or both. So there are two classifications, two categories. The first one is triable by any magistrate. So, if the threat is to cause death or grievous hurt, destruction of any property by fire, to cause an offense to be committed, which is punishable with imprisonment up to a term of 7 years, life imprisonment or death. And the next one is to attribute unchastity to a woman. In the above mentioned situations, the prescribed punishment is simple or rigorous imprisonment for a term extending to 7 years, or a fine, or both. Now, the second category is the magistrate of the first class. In this case, it is important to note that to attract this type of offenses that is triable by only the magistrate of first class, it is essential that there is a threat either causing death or grievous hurt. So these are the two categories for criminal intimidation. So the first category is a non-cognizable, bailable, and non-compoundable offense. The second category is also non-cognizable, bailable, but it is a non-compoundable offense. So guys, this is all about criminal intimidation in criminal law. I hope you guys like the topic. Feel free to share your comments about the topic. Thank you guys.